A developing story that we are following for you today out of Turkey, where anti-American protesters attacked three U.S. Navy sailors in Istanbul, near where the American warship was docked. It's an inlet of the Bosphorus Strait in the Black Sea. Three U.S. sailors attacked. It was a mob that claims to be from something called the Turkey Youth Union, and about 20 nationalists apparently threw objects at the individual, at the member of the American military, chased them, briefly had a bag over one of their heads. Let's go ahead and talk a little bit more about what this, because certainly Turkey is a NATO ally, and we have to figure out exactly what's happening here, and is this just the beginning of something? So let's welcome back to Midpoint, Professor of Middle Eastern Studies at Florida Atlantic University's Department of Political Science, author of Salafism in Lebanon. Dr. Robert Rabil joins us on the phone. Dr. Rabil, good to talk to you again.
And it's my pleasure, Ed. It's my pleasure.
What do we draw out of this? Because there's a couple of ways to look at it. One, it is just a group of kids, young people, in something called the Turkey Youth Union, which may or may not be a big deal. Others is that it does speak to the fact that there's a faction in Turkey that is not happy being closely affiliated with the Americans right now.
Well, as a matter of fact, they are both right. What you just said now, if I want to look at it, and if I want to look at the history in Turkey of the Marxist leftists in Turkey, they had a history of attacking Western targets, including Americans. And I can take you back to the 1970s when you had an organization called the Grey Wolves. What's interesting about this organization is that it claims to embrace Kemalism, Kemal Atatürk's policy, and at the same time, it's left. And this is what's so concerning to me, is that they are against imperialism, against being admitted to the European Union, and at the same time, they support Kemalist views. So it is concerning to me, Ed. And I am hoping, I really hope, it is an isolated incident. But having said that, let's not forget, last year in 2013, you had also another leftist Marxist organization by the name of the Revolutionary People Liberation Party attacked the U.S. Embassy in Ankara. So here, this is why I say what you said could be both true, but I am hoping they are few, and I am hoping that the Turkish government will take action, especially in its public discourse, to support us morally and to support us in any way, really, because it is not right. And I saw the clip, and I saw the young people, and this is something really I hope that I will never see again happening, especially in Istanbul.
Now, we know that ISIS has already sent out a message basically applauding what was done. As I had said earlier to a colleague here, is it not fair to note that ISIS will basically applaud just about anything that is anti-American? So they're pretty much piggybacking on top of this right now. It's not necessarily saying that ISIS is involved. They're simply just trying to become part of the narrative.
Absolutely. I fully agree with you. They're just going to applaud everyone who's attacking the United States. And even if they are leftists, and ISIS, its ideology is totally against Marxists and leftists. And as a matter of fact, they are fighting the Kurds in Kobani, whom they say they are leftists and Marxists. So you are absolutely right. They are just, applauding them because they attacked Americans.
Would you agree, then, I got about 30 seconds left here, that the U.S. Embassy, in blasting the attack, basically tweeted out, the vast majority of Turks are against an action that so disrespects Turkey's reputation for hospitality. Would you agree that probably the majority of Turks would be against something like this, against Americans?
Yes, I agree. I would say a significant number of Turks are against this action. Yes, I do agree with that. Bearing in mind that you have segments of the population now, they harbor anti-American feelings, especially after the U.S. invaded Iraq.
It is worth watching because, again, in that region of the world, we have to watch everything that happens, because even the slightest thing can become some sort of a flashpoint for a larger conflagration. We've certainly talked about that as well.
It's very unfortunate, Ed. Very unfortunate.
It is indeed. Dr. Robert Rabil, always a pleasure to have you on the show, my friend. I'll look forward to the next time you join me here at the desk.
Thank you, Ed. I'll be looking forward to it.
All right, take care. His book, once again, is Salafism in Lebanon, which, by the way, I'm still plowing through, and it is a fascinating book indeed. Up next, from the doctor's mouth to the president's desk, why they might indeed be celebrating with the demise of Obamacare. And at 51 minutes after the hour, crack open the water cooler and find the insulting singer and the homeless feeding frenzy. That and a whole lot more as we continue right here on MidPoint.